So let us go ahead with understanding of some more concepts about the ecosystem. I had last time मैं रुकी थी for ecological efficiencies if I'm not wrong. So let us continue from there. Yeah. So we had stopped at this na. I had explained about the ecological efficiencies to all of you all, and I told you that mathematical calculation based questions are going to be asked on this particular topic, right? Yes, fine. So we go ahead with ecological succession now. What exactly is ecological succession? See, the gradual and predictable change in the species composition of a given area is going to be called as ecological succession. Succession ka matlab hota hai one after another. Okay, so now this change is going to be a very gradual change. Okay, and we can predict the change. We can come to know that what the change is going to be like, because looking at the conditions, looking at the environmental factors, looking at other ecological factors, we can easily predict that now this particular change is going to happen. So the gradual change and the predictable change in the species composition. Okay, so what is going to change? What is going to be gradually, undergoing changes is going to be the species composition. So ek area mein ek x species prevail kar rahi hai, for example. Okay, now in that same area suppose y species has invaded. Okay, ab x and y mein competition hone laga, right? X and y mein competition hone laga. Then just now, like last lectures we have studied about evolution, we know that there is something called as natural selection that's going to prevail. Now X was there in that area for so many years, Y has recently invaded that area, but if Y is better suited, better adapted to that particular condition, then who would survive? X survive karega ki Y survive karega wahan par? Agar Y zyada adapt kar sakta hai to who is the one? Obviously, very correct. Yes, beta. So why will survive? Means what has happened? Due to this gradual competition that is taking place, dheere dheere dheere, X species is becoming extinct, and Y species is going to be dominating that zone, that area. Okay. If at all Y species was not that competent enough, if X was more dominating, so kya ho jata tha? Y aane do, Z aane do, aur koi bhi aane do, X kisi ko उधर अडाप्ट होने का चांस ही नहीं देता था, राइट? देन वी नो वी कैन प्रेडिक्ट बिकॉज एक्स इज सो कॉम्पिटेंट इनफ एंड इट इज नॉट गोइंग टू अलाउ एनी अदर स्पीशीज टू इन्वेड, एक्स इज गोइंग टू बी द यू नो स्पीशीज दैट इज गोइंग टू प्रिवेल इन दैट एरिया. या सो इन यस परफेक्टली बेटा. सो इन दिस केस ना व्हाट इज गोइंग टू हैपन, वी कैन प्रेडिक्ट, वी कैन कम टू नो दैट स्पीशीज कैसे चेंज हो रहे हैं, या फिर कभी कभी क्या होता है, वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट देम इवेंचुअली. दैट इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज कोएग्जिस्टेंस. कोएग्जिस्टेंस में क्या होता है ना, लाइक दे शेयर द रिसोर्सेज. सो मे बी देयर इज ओनली वन रिसोर्स अवेलेबल, सपोज एक ही फूड रिसोर्स अवेलेबल है, देन व्हाट विल हैपन, देयर फोराजिंग टाइम विल बी डिफरेंट. यू नो व्हाट इज फोराजिंग टाइम? ईटिंग टाइम. वो जो खाने के लिए आ जाएंगे ना वो रिसोर्स के लिए, दैट वुड बी एट डिफरेंट टाइम. सो देन देयर इज नो कॉम्पिटिशन, देयर इज म्यूचुअल अंडरस्टैंडिंग. इन दैट केस बोथ द स्पीशीज विल प्रिवेल इन दैट पर्टिकुलर जोन. सो देयर आर वेरियस इंटरैक्शंस दैट यू वुड बी स्टडिंग इन द चैप्टर कॉल्ड एज ऑर्गेनिजम्स एंड पॉपुलेशन, एंड यू विल कम टू नो अबाउट मेनी मेनी मोर थिंग्स लाइक म्यूचुअलिज्म, कॉमेंसालिज्म, अमेंसालिज्म, प्रेडेशन, then competition, exclusive principle of competition. There are many, many which would be coming across the chapter of organisms and population. But as of now, what we have to understand is there's a gradual change, and it's going to be a predictable change. We can come to know that how the species composition of an area is going to get altered. Okay, clear? Okay. Now for this, we have to understand a certain succession. So what are these successions? Dekho, primary succession. A succession that starts where no living organisms are there, that would be called as primary succession. Now for example, when I talk about primary succession, probably abhi ek volcanic eruption hua hai, and baad mein ye jo lava hai wo thanda ho gaya, aur wo ek naya, matlab abhi tak wo lava tha, molten lava tha, wo thanda hone ke baad it has formed a rock, right? अब ये रॉक पे अभी तक देयर इज नो वन हु हैज इन्वेडेड और नो वन हु हैज सक्सेसफुली यू नो नो लाइफ हैज बीन सक्सेसफुली फाउंड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर न्यूली फॉर्म्ड रॉक राइट. अब इसमें जो कोई फर्स्ट लाइफ फॉर्म आके इट विल स्टार्ट द सक्सेशन दैट इज गोइंग टू बी कॉल्ड एज प्राइमरी सक्सेशन. सो व्हेनेवर वी यूज द वर्ड प्राइमरी उसका मतलब क्या होता है, टिल टुडे नो लाइफ फॉर्म एग्जिस्टेड ऑन दिस पर्टिकुलर एरिया. That is going to be called as primary succession. ठीक है, got it? On the other hand, secondary succession क्या होता है? देखो, a succession that starts in an area which have lost all the living organisms that existed once upon a time. तो कभी एक मतलब जमाने में ये area में organisms were there due to some calamities, maybe natural, artificial, whatever it is. Now that area had become barren. There was no life form, seen on that area for thousands of years. And again, in that area, if a new organism is going to be found or a new succession is going to be found, we call it as a secondary succession. So difference between primary and secondary, samjha beta? Primary ka matlab kya hota hai? Primary ka matlab hota hai the one which that area, that particular one area which was never ever invaded by any life forms. Okay. And secondary means once upon a time there were life forms in this zone, in this area. They got completely washed out. They got completely eradicated because of whatever reason. And now again a new life form has started emerging on that zone. That will be called as your secondary succession. ठीक है? ये आपके board exam के questions हैं. One mark के लिए definitions आते हैं. Define primary succession. Define secondary succession. Define ecological succession. This is what they ask you. So you should be very clear about the definitions. Okay. Now let us see what is hydrarch succession and xerarch succession. So hydrarch or hydrarch, whatever you want to say. Hydra means water, right? So the succession that takes place in water will be your hydrarch succession. बराबर जैसे कि newly formed lake अगर कहीं पर है. ओके, न्यूली फॉर्म्ड लेक है तो इस न्यूली फॉर्म्ड लेक में जो सक्सेशन होने वाला है, स्टार्ट होने वाला है लाइफ फॉर्म, मे बी प्राइमरी और व्हाटएवर, दैट विल बी योर हाइड्रार्च सक्सेशन. एंड जेराच मींस यू आर नॉट डेजर्ट्स बेटा. जेराच का मतलब होता है लैंड. ओके, सो द वन विच इज गोइंग टू टेक प्लेस इन द ड्राई एरियाज. ड्राई एरियाज मीन्स ऑन द लैंड, ऑन द लैंड, नॉट इन वॉटर. Then these are your different, you know, like abhi hydrarch could be primary also or secondary also. Xerarch could be primary also or secondary also. There is no rule like that. Okay, na? Samajh mein aa rahi hai baat? Now, what are pioneer species? Pioneers means the one who are going to initiate, the one who are going to start. That's what we call as pioneers. So the species that invade a barren area or a bare area for the first time is going to be called as the pioneer species. What are the examples? See, in case of xerarch succession, it's going to be lichens, and in case of hydrarch succession, it's going to be phytoplanktons. So we already know about the phytoplanktons. We know what are zooplanktons, right? So in the water bodies, the first one to come up as a life are going to be your phytoplanktons. And on land, the first one to develop as life forms are going to be your lichens. Can anyone tell me lichen is an organism made up of which two organisms? What plus what is equal to lichen? Come on, I want answers from you. What is a lichen? What plus what? Very good. Yes, Komal, right. Yes, Pranavi, right. Very good, Shruti. Very good. Come on, others. Good morning. Give me the answers quickly. Three answers coming till now. All are right. Very good, Samiksha. Very nice, my dear. Come on, come on, come on. Others, what's lichen? What plus what? Yes, Sonali. Correct answer. Correct answer. Very good, Sneha Sharma. Yes, Preksha. Very good, Viva. Shreyash, very nice. Nahi. Bacha, ek hi galti hai. You are right with one. Ek hi galti hai wahan par. Come on, others. चलो सब लोग मुझे आंसर दे दो. बाय नाउ यू शुड बी नोइंग व्हाट इज द वर्ड कॉल्ड इज लाइकेन. यस, करेक्ट. Correct. Very nice. Yes, Komal, you are right. You are right, beta. One contributes shelter and the other one is going to give food. Very good. Very good. बाकी लोग किधर खो गए मेरे बच्चे लोग? हाँ, ऐसा मत करो, आंसर दे दो. हाँ यस डेविड जेम्स, यू आर राइट. यस हिमांशु, यू आर राइट, वेरी गुड. सो इट्स गोइंग टू बी व्हाट बेटा? एल्गी एंड फंगाई, राइट? एल्गी प्लस फंगाई इज गोइंग टू बी कॉल्ड एज योर लाइकेंस. प्लीज डोंट फॉरगेट इट. And fungi with the roots of higher plants is going to be your mycorrhiza. So mycorrhiza kya hai, lichens kya hai, coralloid roots kya hai, ye sari cheeze aapko yaad rehni chahiye. Okay, so when I taught you plant kingdom, I told you that coralloid roots are roots of higher plants with blue green algae, or they are called as cyanobacteria. So maine aapko shortcut bhi diya tha, cycas का रूट विथ साइनोबैक्टीरिया इज गोइंग टू बी योर कोरोलाइड. सो मैंने आपको एक हिंट दिया था, ऑल इन सी ग्रुप, सी फॉर साइकस, सी फॉर साइनोबैक्टीरिया, सी फॉर कोरोलाइड रूट्स, राइट? वेल, सो दीज आर द फ्रीक्वेंट क्वेश्चंस. हां, दीज आर द बेसिक थिंग्स दैट यू शुड नो. या दे आर सिम्बायोटिक, यस दे आर सिम्बायोटिक, दैट्स राइट. सो योर लाइकेंस आर गोइंग टू बी द पायोनियर स्पीशीज इन केस ऑफ द terrestrial, you know, or as we say, xerarch systems, while phytoplanktons are going to be your diatoms, right? You remember diatoms, dinoflagellates, yeah. So they are going to be your phytoplanktons. That is going to be in water, of course. So these are going to be called as the pioneer species. Primary succession on rocks are lichens, which are able to secrete acids, which will dissolve the rock, helping in weathering and soil formation. So what does the lichens do? The lichens are going to secrete out certain acids, and these acids will dissolve the rocks. As I said, there arch mein terrestrial hai, newly formed rock hai, newly formed mountain hai, jo bhi hai. So, you know, the lichens will dissolve that rocks, and it will help in weathering of the rocks, and that leads to soil formation. Okay, now what will happen after soil formation? Ek bar soil ban gayi matlab kya hua beta? Definitely koi na koi usme aap grow kar sakta hai, hai na? I'll talk about the succession eventually, of course, in the next slide. But before that, anyone having any difficulty with whatever has been put upon the screen right now in front of you, anyone who has any difficulty in any of the points that have been mentioned, come on, tell me. किसी को कोई भी पॉइंट में डाउट है, डिफिकल्ट है? इकोलॉजिकल सक्सेशन, प्राइमरी सक्सेशन, सेकेंडरी सक्सेशन, हाइड्राज कंडीशन, जेराज कंडीशन, पायोनियर स्पीशीज, यू हैव टू रिमेंबर देम. इट कम्स इन योर बोर्ड्स, इट कम्स इन योर बोर्ड्स. ओके, वेल, then let us see what are the processes of succession and what are the major steps. Now these steps have not been given in your government textbook, nor have they been mentioned anywhere in your NCERT textbooks, but every year there are going to be several questions which are going to be asked on them. Okay, so please understand this very carefully. Please understand this very carefully. What are the process, what are the steps? The first, nudation. Nudation का मतलब होता है एक्सपोजर ऑफ एन एरिया. सो अनलेस एंड अंटिल अ पर्टिकुलर एरिया इज नॉट एक्सपोज्ड, हाउ विल द सक्सेशन टेक प्लेस, राइट? सो दैट एरिया हैज टू बी एक्सपोज्ड वेयर द यू नो इकोलॉजिकल सक्सेशन शुड टेक प्लेस. सो इफ इट्स गोइंग टू बी यू नो द मोल्टन लावा, राइट? नो लाइफ फॉर्म कैन ग्रो इन दैट मोल्टन लावा. सो इट शुड कूल, and after cooling down, then it is going to give, you know, the rock which will be exposed for this succession, right? So the first step of ecological succession is nudation, that is exposure of an area. The second is migration. the process of dispersal of seed spores and other, you know, this propagules, as we say, you know, like the ones which can actually go across. So another structure of the propagation of species. So there could be any propagules. It could be, you know, vegetative propagation, as we say. So any part of it. I guess now it's fine. My voice was lagging. Is it still lagging? Is my voice lagging, my dears? It's okay now. So the process of dispersal of seeds, spores, and other structures of propagation. So there could be any structure. So we know that vegetative reproduction also takes place. So it could be bulbils, or it could be the stem cuttings, or anything like that. Okay, in a bare area is known as migration. So you know what is migration basically. Next is germination. So if a particular spore, or if a particular seed, or if any particular vegetative propagule is going to land on that area, it should have the capacity to germinate. If it does not germinate, what is the use of it? Correct? So first is nodation, second is migration, third is germination. So it occurs only when the conditions are going to be favorable. Okay? Fourth point is something that you have to understand. That is called as ichthyosis. What is it going to be called as? Ichthyosis. Now, what is ichthyosis? See, successful germination of propagules and its establishment in that bare area is known as ichthyosis. So, एक ही अगर propagule germinate हुआ और आगे अगर उसका कुछ नहीं हो पाया तो what is the use again? It should spread, it should colonize, right? So, before colonization, it should have the capacity of establishing itself, right? Establishing itself means sustaining, surviving, and adjusting and adapting to that particular condition. That is called as ichthyosis. So adapting and accepting the prevailing condition is ichthyosis. So successful germination of propagules and its establishment in a bare area. Okay, it is called as ichthyosis. So nodation, migration, germination. ठीक है ना, राइट? फिफ्थ देखो, कॉलोनाइजेशन एंड एग्रीगेशन. सो आफ्टर इकोसेसिस, वंस दे हैव यू नो दे हैव एस्टैब्लिश्ड देमसेल्व्स इन दैट पर्टिकुलर एरिया, देन व्हाट शुड हैपन? सी, दे शुड रिप्रोड्यूस, दे शुड मल्टीप्लाई, दे शुड फॉर्म कॉलोनीज. सो सी, आफ्टर इकोसेसिस द इंडिविजुअल्स ऑफ द सेम स्पीशीज इंक्रीज इन नंबर एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन. So that is colonization and aggregation. Then comes competition and coaction. So due to limited resources, species show both interspecific competition and intraspecific competition. This results into the elimination of unsuitable and weaker plants. So here, as I said, that survival of the fittest. The nature is going to only pick up the one which is going to be perfectly adapted to that condition. The other will automatically get eliminated. So here comes your competition. It could be competition which is interspecific, that is between two different species, or it could be intraspecific within its own species. Correct? So it could be anything. And then the seventh one is invasion, that is various other types of plants will try to establish in the spaces left by the elimination of the previous plants due to competition. So wherever there is going to be space, new organisms will try to come and, you know, establish themselves in that particular area wherever there is space. See, take our own example, right? Initially, what happened? People were staying only on the, you know, houses made up of mud and, you know, made up of that small hut huts type of a thing on land, right? उसके बाद क्या हो गया बेटा? एक के ऊपर एक ऐसे दो मंजिलें आ गई, two floors, then three floors, then seven floors, then towers, 21 floors, हाँ, 40 फ्लोर्स, बड़े 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 टॉवर्स आने लगे बेटा. यस, बिग ह्यूज टॉवर्स आर स्टिल कमिंग अप, दे आर स्टिल कमिंग अप एंड दे वोंट स्टॉप. तो स्पेस का जैसे लिमिटेशन हो गया, जहां कहां स्पेस है, वी हैव स्टार्टेड व्हाट, इनवेडिंग. हमने सारे फॉरेस्ट तोड़ दिए, जिधर जिधर हो सकता है उधर उधर कॉन्क्रीट हमने, मतलब कॉन्क्रिटाइजेशन कहते हैं उसको, है ना, उधर स्टार्ट कर दिया. वेर एवर लाइक आई, यू नो लाइक वेर आई स्टे नाउ इन बोरिवली, व्हेन वी आर शिफ्टेड टू बोरिवली सम 30 इयर्स बिफोर, इनिशियली आई स्टेड इन बांद्रा. माय लाइफ वाज, माय चाइल्डहुड डेज वर इन बांद्रा. आई यूज्ड टू स्टे एट बांद्रा, देन वी शिफ्टेड टू बोरिवली. And I remember that time where I stay now, na, after my marriage, where I stay now, there we had never ever thought of even going for roaming in that zone. Yes, Borivali wala jungle tha ye, idhar pura jungle wala area tha ye. It was actually a jungle. It was a, you know, like a dense forest type of thing. We used to get scared. We used to come cycling, na. हम लोग cycling के लिए आते थे सारे friends, na. So whenever we used to go out for cycling, na, एक particular area तक we used to come. And after that area, डर लगता था, because वहाँ पर पूरा jungle ही jungle था. मतलब even when we used to come near my place where I stay now, near to that, not in that dislocation, थोड़ा at a distance also, na. There also we were fearing. There also we used to, you know, like experience many snakes and mongoose and all those things. Yeah, yeah, yeah. There were jackals. There were everyone. We have seen them in Borivali where I stay now. This house where I'm staying now was once upon a time a major, you know, like a jungle. Yes, 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 yes. You can easily see. So, you know, like Borivali East side, we used to never go there near the national park area, because even today we can, you know, like my friends and all who stay there, na, from their balconies and all, you can see that cheetah and, you know, tigers and wildcats. You can see them even today. Like one of my friends ke compound wall share karte hai wo almost, to wahan par to unke compound mein bhi aake baith jate hai ye wildcats karke. But even in my area it was like that way once upon a time. We had never thought of it, but now what is the condition? फॉरेस्ट वॉरेस्ट छोड़ो, एक पेड़ भी नहीं मिलता है अभी यहाँ पर ये एरिया में. इन्वेजन, सो जहां जहां हमें मिले हम लोग इन्वेड करते जाते हैं बेटा. सो द सेम दैट आइडियोलॉजी इज द सेम, इवन द सेम थिंग हैपेंस विद प्लांट्स. सी योर, लुक एट योर ओन कंपाउंड. थोड़ा सा बारिश हुआ नहीं, तुम्हारा अगर कंपाउंड में अगर टाइल्स लगाए है ना, वो पेवर ब्लॉक्स लगाए है ना, यू कैन सी स्मॉल, यू नो लाइक प्लांट्स ग्रोइंग आउट ऑफ इट. हैव यू ऑल सीन, होता है तुम्हारे यहाँ पर ऐसा? My compound has got so many things like this way. Small, you know, like, yeah, moss has come up. Then small, you know, like grasses have erupted from between the space between the two paver blocks. Jahan space hai, wahan invasion hota hai. That's for sure. Okay? You keep your window on and the lizards are the first one to invade your houses. If you have got crevices in your wall, if you have got crevices in your washroom, कॉकरोचेस का इन्वेजन पक्का है, करेक्ट? सो दैट इज व्हाट इज इन्वेजन बेटा. व्हेरेवर स्पेस वुड बी प्रेजेंट, द अदर स्पीशीज वुड ऑलवेज ट्राई टू एस्टैब्लिश इन दैट जोन, विल ऑलवेज ट्राई टू, यू नो लाइक इन्वेड दैट एरिया, डोमिनेट दैट एरिया एंड कैप्चर दैट एरिया फॉर इट्स ओन. ओके, सो दीज आर द सेवन स्टेप्स ऑफ सक्सेशन. On this slide, you can see nudation, migration, germination, ecchymosis, colonization and aggregation, competition and coaction, and invasion. Any doubts with any of these, my dears? Anyone who has not followed these major steps of ecological succession? All are okay? Good. Do not forget the chronology, what comes after what. Okay? So, then we go ahead with the eighth one. There are 10 steps, don't worry, not more than that. So the eighth one is going to be called as reaction. Now, as invasion has taken place, what is the next thing that will happen? आपके पास कार पार्किंग का इशू है क्या बेटा कंपाउंड में आपके? मेरे इधर बहुत ज्यादा नाटक है. मेरे इधर इतना नाटक है कि किसी की कार निकली नहीं, किसी ने देखा नहीं कि इसकी कार निकल गई है बालकनी में से, फटाक से वो अपनी कार उधर लाके रख देगा और फिर रिएक्शन स्टार्ट होते है या नहीं? हाँ हाँ मेरे इधर तो बहुत होते हैं, परेशान हो गई मैं वो रिएक्शन दे देकर. व्हाट आर द रिएक्शंस? सी द न्यूली अराइव्ड प्लांट्स इंटरप्ट विद द एग्जिस्टिंग वंस. ऑब्वियसली एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ रिएक्शन एनवायरमेंट इज मॉडिफाइड एंड बिकम्स अनसुटेबल फॉर द एग्जिस्टिंग कम्युनिटीज व्हिच सूनर और लेटर इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय अनदर कम्युनिटी. सो इन आवर केस एज आई सेड व्हाट हैपेंस इज There is always a fight between the car spaces. Parking कम है, tenants हम लोग ज़्यादा है, we are more people in the society and there is a parking issue. It's a, you know, like a, not a newly constructed building, na. So that time, इतना किसने सोचा था कि, you know, like people will have every flat will have a car करके. That time the builders never thought of it. Now what has happened? Because of this everyday का reaction, na. सीरियसली लगता है यार अभी इधर नहीं, अभी कोई अच्छा दूसरा जगह पर जाए जहाँ पर अपना खुद का पार्किंग स्पेस हो. सो व्हाट हैपेंस? वन गेट्स एलिमिनेटेड, राइट? अभी नया कोई किसी ने फ्लैट लिया है हमारे सोसाइटी में, अगर किसी नए बंदे ने फ्लैट लिया है, उसकी खुद की उसकी कार है, तो क्या हो गया? इंटरप्टिंग विद द एग्जिस्टिंग वन. सो ओ माई गॉड, आए तो गेट लाइक ओ माई गॉड, अभी और एक नए लोग आ गए इधर रहने के लिए, इनकी तो दो दो कारें हैं ऑलरेडी, हमारी इधर झिकझिक चल रही है और इनका किधर रखेंगे? तो इंटरप्शन हो गया कि नहीं? सो द न्यूली अराइव्ड वंस आर गोइंग टू इंटरप्ट विद द एग्जिस्टिंग वंस. एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ रिएक्शन एनवायरमेंट इज मॉडिफाइड. परेशान हो गए सब लोग, जितने भी लोग सोसाइटी में रहते, ऑल आर यू नो बहुत चिक-चिक हो रही है एंड दे बिकम इट द कंडीशंस बिकम अनफेवरेबल अनसुटेबल फॉर द एग्जिस्टिंग कम्युनिटीज Which sooner or later is replaced by another one. तो अगर हम लोग भी छोड़ के जाएंगे तो थोड़ी ना इसको चैरिटी में दे देंगे घर को, किसी और को बेच के ही जाएंगे ना. मतलब रिप्लेसमेंट हुआ कि नहीं? Some other people will come and stay in this area or no? That is called as reaction, but so that happens in nature also. So already there are certain plants which have invaded the terrestrial regions and new plants have arrived. And because of the new entry, the existing ones got interrupted, and there was like reactions to it. Of course, either there are two possibilities in this case, that either the one who is new will all get eliminated, or if that one is a dominant one, stronger one, then the existing will get eliminated. So who will get eliminated will depend on what? Survival of the fittest, natural selection. Okay. So after invasion, there is going to be reaction. Then the ninth is stabilization. So finally, if there is mutual understanding between the two communities who are sharing that same area, if there is, mutual understanding, na? Ki chalo bhai, tu bhi kuch, main bhi kuch, samajh ke isme se koi way out nikalte hai. Let us see what can best happen with us, right? That is stabilization. So see, the process when the final climax community becomes more or less stabilized for a longer period of time and it can maintain itself in equilibrium with the climate of the area, then we call it as stabilization. So what do you mean by that? Whatever the conditions are, if there is mutual understanding between the neighbors, between your, you know, society members, then what can happen? Chalo fine, mil jul ke rahenge, jhagda jhagdi nahi karenge, adjust karne ki koshish karenge, jo ho sakta hai wo best, you know, like ye karke beech ka ek kya kehte hai, ek way out nikal ke, let us live in harmony, then there is going to be what? Stabilization. No one is going to go out, no one is going to come in, everything is going to be like, you know, in proper place. The same thing happens in case of your nature also. Now there is going to be stabilization. That is going to be called as climax community. Means no more entries, no more exits. Okay, कोई exit नहीं करेगा, कोई entry नहीं लेगा. Almost stable हो गया उधर का पूरा condition. Why? Because whatever or whoever is now present in that area has got adapted to the climatic conditions of that particular area in nature. I'm talking about, right? So see. as compared to the transitional communities, the climax community has larger size of individuals. Transitional means जो आते जाते रहते हैं ना, आज आए कल गए वापस नए आए फिर गए, उनसे comparison करेंगे तो जो climax communities के individuals है, they are going to be more of larger size. Then they are going to have complex organization, complex food chains and food webs, more efficient energy and more nutrient conservation. So these all things are going to be selected by nature. Only those which are going to be capable of fulfilling these criteria, only they will be selected by nature for climax community. Okay, so the climax community has a larger size of individuals. They have got complex organization, complex food chain, food webs, more efficiency in energy conservation also, and transport also, and more nutrient conservation also. Okay, so that's called as stabilization. And lastly, there is something called as sustenance. You know what is sustenance, na? To sustain means to become permanent. Okay, so once the species reach the mesic conditions, mesic ka matlab hota hai not too dry, not too wet. Wo wet bhi nahi hai aur dry bhi nahi hai. Moderate conditions hai. Okay, so once the species reach the mesic conditions, they become permanent. They become permanent dwellers of that area due to sustenance. You can sustain there, they can sustain there, they can live happily in that zone for years together. Okay, so these are the 10 major steps that are involved in ecological succession. Let it be hydraj, let it be zeraj, koi farak nahi padta hai. Theek hai? So kaun kaun se steps hai? Sabse pehle tha nudation, fir chalo yaad hai aap log ko, would you all help me? Nudation, migration, germination, ichthyosis. Very good. Yes, yes. Fourth one was ichthyosis, colonization and aggregation. Then competition and coaction, invasion, reaction, stabilization, sustenance. 10. Okay. Remember, एक के बाद एक कौन कैसे आता है, हाँ ठीक है ना. Any difficulty, any doubts in understanding these 10 major steps which are involved in making a climax community? So now imagine, once upon a time it was a barren rock, or once upon a time it was a newly formed lake, and now it has got converted into a forest community. That is going to be, you know, like a mesic community, neither too dry nor too wet. Okay, so in this way beta, it will take thousands of years for any forest formation, and it won't take even months to cut off all those forests and get it converted into concretization. So all these forests have taken thousands of years to actually get converted into forests to form climax communities. And look at us, what do? We are not bothered about it. Kya farak padta hai, ye barren land hai, forest ka kya karna hai, trees ko tod do, nikal do, naya building construct karenge, लाखों का प्रॉफिट हो जाएगा, करोड़ों का प्रॉफिट हो जाएगा. आपने को पैसे कमाने हैं, आपने को क्या लेना देना है इकोलॉजी से, है ना. दिस इज द फैक्ट. ओके, सो इट टेक्स अ वेरी लॉन्ग टाइम फॉर एनी क्लाइमैक्स कम्युनिटी टू एस्टैब्लिश इन अ पर्टिकुलर एरिया. गॉट दिस वेरी क्लियरली? एनीवन हु इज हैविंग एनी प्रॉब्लम विद अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ दिस? ओके, let us talk about the primary succession with these 10 major steps. The first step is going to be phytoplanktons. You can see over here, can you see? This is phytoplanktons. Here you can see second one to come into existence after phytoplanktons, or along with phytoplanktons, are submerged plant. So it's the submerged plant stage. The third one is, along with phytoplanktons and submerged, there are floating plants. Can you see? The third is submerged along with free floating stage. Look at the fifth one, reed swamp stage. So here now there are reeds which are coming up, and there is swampy area, marshy area over here now. So water has now started getting converted into what, my dears? Somewhat land and water ka mixture. Wo chikhal kehte hum log usko, chikhal marathi mein, hindi mein kichad kehte hum log. So aisa ek muddy marshy area idhar abhi form hone laga hai, right? That is your reed swamp area. Look at this. This is marsh meadows. So now that marshy areas and there's, you know, like small herbs and shrubs and all of them are growing. So it's called as a meadow stage. Look at the sixth one, scrub stage. Scrub mein, along with those herbs, shrubs, you want to have, short plants or small plants or one or two tall plants also. And look at the seventh one, which is called as the climax community, a forest. So if you look from a lake, a forest can be formed. Of course, it looks very simple, but it is going to take thousands of years for this formation. Okay, so phytoplankton followed by submerged plant, followed by submerged and floating, followed by reed swamp, followed by marsh meadow, followed by scrub, and finally you will get the climax community called as the forest. Is it okay? You'll have to remember this, and this diagram should be read in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. Generally we look like this way: phytoplankton, reed swamp, submerged, marshmallow. Nahi beta, aisa nahi hai. एक दो तीन एक के नीचे एक है, चार पांच छह एक के नीचे एक है. सो इसीलिए मैंने यहाँ पर इनके नाम भी ऐसे ही लिखे हैं. फाइटोप्लैंक्टन, सबमर्ज प्लांट स्टेज, सबमर्ज अलोंग विद फ्री फ्लोटिंग स्टेज, रीड स्वैम्प स्टेज, मार्श मेडो स्टेज, स्क्रब स्टेज एंड फॉरेस्ट. दिस डायग्राम इज इन योर एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट बुक एंड दे फ्रीक्वेंटली आस्क यू क्वेश्चंस ऑन दिस एज ए बी सी डी एंड यू हैव टू पिक अप द राइट लेबल्स फॉर इट. सो please look at the diagram very carefully of your books and then answer the questions. Okay, well, that's about your ecological succession altogether. And finally we come to the concluding part of this chapter, that is nutrient cycling or biogeochemical cycling. Theek hai, but before that, anyone having any difficulty with ecological succession? Anyone who did not understand any point? Okay, these stages or these steps which we saw, na, the major 10 steps that we saw, they are called as seral stages, S-E-R-A-L, seral stages, just like a series, just like a series, ek ke baad ek. Okay, it takes thousands of years but to make a forest, thousands of years. Okay, from the scratch, as I say, from the scratch. Okay, yeah, so you remember that word seral stages, that is not mentioned here, but remember it's called as seral, S-E-R-A-L, seral stages. That is, nudation is the first seral stage, migration is the next seral stage. Okay, so ek ke baad ek jo stages aate hai na, unko hum kehte hai seral stages. Okay, sure. Finally we come to the nutrient cycling and biogeochemical cycling. We have already described about the nitrogen cycle in the chapter called as mineral nutrition. So two more cycles are remaining to understand. One is carbon cycle and one is phosphorus cycle. So let us look at it as well. Movement of nutrient elements through the various components of an ecosystem, as between biotic and non-biotic components, is called as nutrient cycling. So we know there was something called as atmospheric pool and soil, and in between there was rhizobium, which was living organism in nitrogen. Nitrogen cycle, right? Well, here, what do you mean by the word gaseous cycle? Cycle which have its reservoirs of the nutrients in the atmosphere are going to be called as gaseous cycles. For example, carbon cycle, nitrogen cycle are gaseous cycles. What is sedimentary cycles? So the cycles which are going to have its reservoir of the nutrient in the earth's crust will be called as sedimentary cycle. For example, phosphorus cycle and sulfur cycle. Now, you know, like they give this particular question very often in your exams, that select the odd one out. In that, they give carbon cycle, nitrogen cycle, oxygen cycle, and phosphorus cycle. So all three others are your gaseous cycles, while phosphorus is going to be your sedimentary. Okay. Well, look at the carbon cycle. Very beautifully explained in a very simple form. I'll just talk about it. See, CO2 in atmosphere and in dissolved oxygen. This is going to be the reservoir. So here is the reservoir of CO2. How does it get accumulated in the atmosphere or get dissolved in water? Okay. So here we come with our producers. For producers, what you require? See, the CO2 from the atmosphere. I hope you all remember the C3 pathway, the C4 pathway, and all those things. So for photosynthesis, your CO2 will be taken up by the green plants. Correct. The green plants will use this carbon dioxide. They'll convert it either in the form of sugars, or they'll be consuming themselves. They'll be utilizing energy with that. Or the green plant may be eaten by plant. So let us first talk about this. If the animal is going to be eaten, if the plant is going to be eaten by the animal, then the animal has got two options. Either it, after dying, it will decay and will add that particular CO2 source in the soil, which will get dissolved, carbonic acids. Otherwise, the animal in its metabolism and respiration is also going to give out CO2, which will be accumulated in the green plants. Even may undergo death, and even they respire. Okay, so even during their respiration, they are going to add up CO2 in the atmosphere. If the plants are going to be respiration and metabolism of green plants are also going to add up to the atmospheric CO2. If the green plants are going to be used as fuels, then the fuels will undergo combustion, directly CO2. So this is going to be the reservoir. So atmosphere and dissolved water will contain CO2. Okay, will contain CO2. So this is the basic idea of your carbon cycle. Very simple and very easy to remember, of course. The same thing they have given in this chart form. This diagram is there in your books. You can go through it. No question has been asked based on the diagram. Whatever diagram has been given, the same thing, that diagram has been mentioned. Carbon constitutes 49% of dry weight of an organism. 0.0003% of CO2 is present in atmosphere. Carbon is fixed in the biosphere through photosynthesis. We know this. Carbon returns to the atmosphere as CO2 through the respiratory activities of the producers and the consumers. Decomposers also contribute some amount of CO2 from dead organic matter, burning of wood, forest fire, combustion of organic matter, fossil fuels, volcanic eruptions are additional sources of releasing CO2 in the atmosphere. So this is how the CO2 is going to be, released into the atmosphere and will be used also by the green plants for photosynthesis. That's the only role. That's all with your carbon cycle. So I guess there is no problem with the carbon. It's simple, right? Phosphorus is all the more simple. Phosphorus may, this is going to be the source, that is your rocks, mineral rocks, or the earth's crust, which is going to have these rocks, will be the source. What will happen? The phosphorus will undergo weathering. The rocks will undergo weathering and they'll form soil solution. Okay, now from the soil, in the form of phosphoric acid, the producers are going to pick up phosphoric acid. Okay, that is going to be your green plants. Two fates of the green plants: one, eaten by the consumer; second, the litter fall. That is, they will dry and they'll fall down. If they fall down, they'll be acted upon by the detritus, right? And it will undergo decomposition again to add that phosphorus to the soil solution. If it is consumed by the consumer is also going to die eventually. Even it is going to be broken down by the detritus and decomposition will take place, causing the formation of soil solution. So here there is something called as runoff, which you need to remember. Runoff wala is the one which will then undergo precipitation. Do you remember catabolism, precipitation that we had done in the last class? So that precipitation wala salt, this phosphate salts, will then get precipitated from the runoff water and again will be brought to the soil. Okay? So this is going to be your phosphorus cycle. Now here, if you look at the arrows, please pay attention to the arrows, beta. It's soil solution से rock minerals के तरफ arrow नहीं जाता है. ये एक और ये दो arrow नीचे की तरफ है. But this rock minerals से arrow ऊपर जा रहा है. Okay? So please pay attention to the arrows. In your examinations also, they'll give this as A B C D, and you will make a blunder. So look at the arrows very correctly. Fine. So this is your phosphorus cycle ka diagram. Any difficulty till now? Carbon and phosphorus. Simple. Phosphorus is a major source, a major constituent of the organism. It is found in nucleic acid, cellular energy transfer systems. That's your ATP. Many animals also need large quantity of this element to make shells, bones, teeth, etc. The natural reservoir of phosphorus is going to be the rock. In water, it contains in the form of phosphates, right? So phosphates and phosphoric acids, basically. When rocks are weathered, minute amounts of phosphates dissolve in soil solution and are absorbed by the roots of the plants. We have already done this in mineral nutrition about the phosphate, their role also. Herbivores and other animals obtain these elements from the plants. The waste products and the dead organisms are decomposed by the phosphate solubilizing bacteria, which will eventually release phosphates back to the soil. So phosphate will never enter the atmospheric pool. वो कभी भी gaseous form में नहीं होता है बेटा, वो हमेशा sedimentary form में ही मिलता है. So there is no escaping of phosphate gas करके कुछ बनता ही नहीं है. ठीक है, got it? So this is about your phosphate cycle. So two cycles, carbon and phosphate in this chapter, and nitrogen cycle in the mineral nutrition chapter. So for your 12th standard, you have got three cycles to be learned precisely. Any difficulty? Any doubts? Anyone having any problem with understanding of these? Simple, eh? Good. Yeah. Now this is something which is very important. As a human being, this is very important. That is ecosystem services. What the ecosystem serves us. So the products of ecosystem processes are called as ecosystem services. For example, forest ecosystem purifies air and water. It avoids droughts and floods. It cycles nutrients and generates fertilized soils, basically. Hai na? So fertility of the soil is maintained because of this recycling of nutrients. It provides wildlife habitat. It maintains biodiversity. It provides storage site for carbon as well. It also provides aesthetic, cultural, and spiritual values. So ye sare ecosystem ki services hai, ye sare ecosystem ke products hai, ye hamare liye serve karta hai. Okay, so you understood there are so many services offered by the ecosystem to the mankind, right? So aesthetic, cultural, and spiritual samjhana. What is aesthetic, beta? What do you mean by the word aesthetic? What is the meaning of aesthetic? Come on, it's normal English language. It's not your scientific language. Yes, yes, artistic, good looking, hai na? It makes, it beautifies our planet, basically. Cultural, kuch achha hua, to bhi hum log flowers offer karte hai. और कोई एक्सपायर हो गया ना तो भी हम लोग फ्लावर्स ही ऑफर करते हैं, करेक्ट? सो कल्चरल वैल्यू है उसको. स्पिरिचुअल, यस, देयर आर यू नो लाइक मेनी फ्लावर्स व्हिच आर कंसीडर्ड फेवरेट बाय सर्टेन गॉड्स. हैव यू ऑल हर्ड अबाउट दैट? व्हाइट कलर का फ्लावर इसको पसंद है, रेड कलर का फ्लावर उसको पसंद है. सो देयर आर स्पिरिचुअल यू नो सेंटिमेंटल इमोशंस आल्सो अटैच्ड विद इट. And there are others also. Like I'm very sorry to say this, but you know I'm forced to say this. But when I was of your age, na, when I was in 11th standard, moving to 12th standard, and all those two years of my college life, that time seriously, you know, that is the time when you have to enjoy your life, and you all are sitting at home and really feel very bad about it. We had rose days and all those in our college, you know. So you could see a variety of rose ke colors that time. Matlab white se lekar black tak sare roses humne dekhe hue the college mein, koi kisi ko de raha hai. White for peace, yellow for friendship. I don't know what was the significance. Haan, black also. Yes, black rose bhi diya tha. Mere ek फ्रेंड ने मेरे दूसरे एक फ्रेंड को दिया था ब्लैक रोज. उनकी बहुत दुश्मनी थी, बहुत दुश्मनी. पता नहीं इतने जेलस थे ना वो एक दूसरे के. आई डोंट नो व्हाई, बट देयर वाज अ लॉट ऑफ जेलसी बिटवीन देम. एंड इट वाज लाइक, सी ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम ना, व्हेन वी वर इन कॉलेज एंड ऑल, ना 11th 12th स्टैंडर्ड में ना बेटा, दैट टाइम साइंस वॉज जस्ट अ स्ट्रीम कॉल्ड अ साइंस. देयर वॉज नो स्ट्रीम लाइक इंजीनियरिंग है, मेडिकल है. बीएससी वाला भी साइंस मतलब नॉर्मल पढ़ता था. ये अपना जो डॉक्टर बनना चाहता है वो भी, जो इंजीनियर बनना चाहता है वो भी, जो आईटी बीएससी आईटी करना चाहता है वो भी, जो फार्मेसी करना चाहता है वो भी. तब ऐसा कुछ स्पेशलाइजेशन नहीं था. नो नो, आई हैड डिसाइडेड फर्स्ट ओनली दैट आई हैव टू गो फॉर मेडिसिन, बट आई हैड टू स्टडी इन अ जनरल साइंस कॉलेज. सो देयर वाज यू नो लाइक नो स्पेशलाइजेशन, दैट ओनली पीसीबी पढ़ाया जाएगा स्पेसिफिकली, एवरीथिंग लाइक यू नो जनरल थिंग. सो देयर वाज सो मेनी लाइक, my college was so huge, and in my 11th standard mein mere akeli ke division mein there were almost more than 200 students in one class, one division. Like that way we had 7 divisions for 11th standard science ke akele. Commerce aur arts ko bhar bhar ke the log. So wahan par kya hota tha, you know, like everyone used to like, abhi college function hai to chahe arts ke bacche ho, chahe science ke ho, chahe commerce ke ho, all are sharing the same college and the same premises. So we had friends with commerce people also, arts people also, everywhere. So that was actually a fun. Pura hamara college bhara hua tha. It was a huge college, of course. Bahut bada college. Xavier's is like a very huge one. So that time I had actually, you know, that's what I'm saying, that my 11th and 12th na actually I had enjoyed the most. Maximum enjoyment when 11th, 12th mein ki thi. And I'm feeling so sad and bad for you all that you all are sitting at home and just, you know, I know, bacha, you tum log ne college dekha hi nahi hai, bhai to bol rahi hu na, mujhe bhai to batane mein bhi kaise matlab kya karu. But seriously, these are the 2 years na, were my, at least for me, they were like ek alag level ki khushi thi wo time pe. Mast maze karte the hum log. So abhi to almost mera portion khatam hone ko aaya hai. Hopefully we'll meet each other soon. I swear, but even I think the same. But I hope we will see each other soon. Na, फिर मैं तुम्हें बहुत मेरे मतलब मेरे कॉलेज की और हमने क्या क्या मस्ती की थी ये सब मैं तुम्हें ना वन टू वन मिलूंगी तब बताऊंगी, पक्का बताऊंगी. एक दिन हम लोग ऐसा ही रखेंगे इंटरेक्शन वाला. तो यू ऑल विल टेल मी अबाउट योर स्टोरीज, आई विल टेल यू अबाउट माई डिफरेंट यू नो एक्सपीरियंसिस एंड ऑल फन दैट आई हैड टिल टुडे. अलग अलग किस्से, अलग अलग कहानियाँ, सब हम लोग एक दिन ऐसा है ना पूरा इंटरेक्टिव सेशन रखेंगे, है ना, थोड़ा सा हटके वाला एक दिन अपना रहेगा श्योर. तो तब हम लोग बहुत मस्त मजा कर लेंगे, उसके लिए हमें मिलना तो चाहिए. लेट्स कीप आवर फिंगर्स क्रॉस्ड. एनीवे, सो हाँ हाँ, जो भी आपको अरे वाई ओनली कॉफी, मजा ले लेंगे उसमें क्या. हाँ, going discussing, are nothing like that, but what happens is, you know, these all lectures are going to get recorded. You will get this recorded lecture. Fir meri ye matlab waise dekha jaye to irrelevant kahaniyan abhi sunane ke liye fir tum log wapas bore na ho jao. To jaise aamne samne rahenge to kuch baatein tum log karoge, kuch baatein main karungi to aur maza aayega. Abhi to filhal main hi bad 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 karti hu na, tum log to sirf sun rahe ho. So that time even you all will talk, so I'll listen. Even I am keen to listen to your kahanis, your funny episodes in life and whatever, you know, like we'll definitely have that session very soon, I hope. Now yesterday only I saw Mumbai was having only 529 cases, so ha, wo kar sakte, that we can do after we complete the portion na. Yes, pakka pakka. Okay, so I hope you all have understood the words aesthetic, cultural, and spiritual. Na, that is more important, correct? Well, then you know because they are giving us so many ecological services. If anyone gives you services, you have to give them something back, na? So there is this person called as Robert Constanza. Don't forget his name. He and his colleagues have put tags, you know, labels for the services. तो हम अगर कुछ भी खरीदते हैं तो उसके ऊपर प्राइस टैग होती है ना, वैसे ये रॉबर्ट कॉन्स्टांजा ने ना एक प्राइस टैग चिपकाई हुई है. सो व्हाट इज दैट, देखो रॉबर्ट कॉन्स्टांजा एंड हिज कलीग्स हैव रिसेंटली ट्राइड टू पुट प्राइस टैग्स फॉर द नेचर्स लाइफ सपोर्ट सर्विसेज. रिसर्चर्स हैव पुट एन एवरेज प्राइस टैग ऑफ $33 trillion पर ईयर on these fundamental ecosystem services which are largely taken for granted because they are free. Seriously, because they are free na, we don't have its value. Agar ye services ke liye hame paisa dena padta tha to kitna paisa dena padta tha, dekhiye $33 trillion per year. Imagine, this is nearly twice the value of the global gross natural product, that is the GNP, which is $18 trillion. जी डी पी यूएस का वो बोल रहे हैं 18 trillion है और हमें उससे डबल ऑलमोस्ट वैल्यू देनी पड़ती थी. आउट ऑफ टोटल कॉस्ट ऑफ वेरियस इकोसिस्टम सर्विसेज द सॉइल फॉर्मेशन अकाउंट्स फॉर अबाउट 50% एंड कंट्रीब्यूट्स ऑफ द अदर सर्विसेज लाइक रिक्रिएशनल एंड न्यूट्रिशनल साइक्लिंग इज अराउंड 10% ईच. सो लुक एट द टैग्स, कितना हैवी प्राइस है. देखो the cost of climate regulation and habitat for wildlife is about 6% each. So 18 33 ka half would be for soil formation, 10% for recycling of the nutrients, 10% for recreational purposes, 6% for climate regulation, and 6% for habitat. So itna bada hame price tag actually bharna chahiye to the ecosystem. But because it is free of cost, हमें कुछ पड़ी नहीं रहती. But Robert Constanza has actually worked out these, and he is saying that this is what we have to actually pay. You have to remember the values. What is 50%? What is 10%? What is 6%? How many total amount? What is the US dollar का GDP? कितने dollars में आता है US का GDP? Everything needs to be remembered, beta. Regular questions have been put forward in this particular part. Okay. Got it with ecological services. All the best with this particular chapter. We have completed this chapter entirely, and as I had told you all in the last class that I'll complete this chapter, I'll send the PDF today only. It's ready already, so I'll send the PDF today. And as I have promised, I'll complete this chapter. I've completed it, and I'm also starting with the next chapter, which is. Actually, not the next chapter. It's in connection with this chapter only. So, as I said, there are 4 chapters of ecology. All these 4 are, you know, interconnected with each other. So, I go to the next chapter, which is also very simple and easy. Ha, weightage of ecosystem is maximum. Ecosystem ke chapters pe, matlab ecology ke ye jo 4 chapters hai na beta, uske upar sabse zyada questions aate hain. A very good weightage is given to them. Okay, but of course, focus on your NCERT language. Predominantly asked from NCERT, right? Well, so whenever you would be, you know, like looking at the what we say recordings, so yaad rakhiyega that a part of ecology and a part of biodiversity is clubbed together, right? नीट 2022 भाई मेरे, नीट 2021 अभी तक पता नहीं चला है कब है, तो 22 का तो अभी से कैसे बोले, बट होपफुली इट विल बी इन द यू नो लाइक नीट 2021 का नीट इज एक्सपेक्टेड ऑन 1st of August, बट इफ इट वुड बी टेकिंग प्लेस इन 1st of August देन योर नीट विल बी श्योरली टेकिंग प्लेस इन May 2022 फॉर श्योर, बिकॉज बाय दैट टाइम मेजोरिटी ऑफ द कैंडिडेट्स वुड गेट वैक्सीनेटेड. And there's going to be safety everywhere then, so there should not be any delay from 2022 onwards is what is expected as of now. Okay, yeah, 1st August ko hai, aise chal raha hai, abhi tak official आए हैं, बट 99.9% इज गोइंग टू बी ऑगस्ट 1st. Now those kids are actually waiting. कब हो जाए करके. अभी इतना हो गया रिविजन री रिविजन री री रिविजन. नाउ दे आर लाइक नो नो योर मीट वोंट गेट पोस्टपोन. Yours would be in time. May में होता है. Normally it's going to be the first Sunday of May. So I don't think so your batch would have any delay with me. Okay. Well, so this is going to be the biodiversity and conservation chapter. This is also very easy. This is also a very simple one. We have heard about it from our, you know, young days. So we know many things about it. Well. Let us go ahead with this. The term biodiversity was introduced by an American biologist whose name is Edward Wilson. He is that person called as Edward Wilson. Biodiversity refers to the variety of life forms as well as the different types of habitats which are going to be found in a defined area. It represents the totality of the genes, species, and ecosystem of a given region. So if we take an area called as Mumbai, if you considered all the living forms, right from all the plants to the maximum evolved human beings, imagine the pool having the number of different genes, imagine the different species that are present in Mumbai, and imagine the ecosystem that prevails in Mumbai. Okay, so in a particular area, we have to understand what are the different genes, how the genes would be defined as a pool. So jitne zyada diverse organisms is area mein hain utne zyada genes ke alag alag alleles available honge. Mumbai mein maximum genes ki gene pool sabse varied gene pool Mumbai ka hoga na, correct? Because Mumbai is, you know, it's going to be, you know, like a khichdi of all different people coming and staying over here, only with respect to human beings only. See, sab jagah ke log Mumbai aake settle ho jate hain. They want to settle in Mumbai. So maximum gene pool diversity also is going to be in Mumbai, as I say always. Species, yeah, species bole to human beings is only one species, that is Homo sapiens. Other species in Mumbai maybe, you know, like not as, you know, like great as found in the Amazon forest, but haan hai, apne idhar bhi hai, not bilkul bhi nahi hai, aisa nahi hai. And the ecosystem that we have got Juhu Beach, we have got Bandstand, right? We have got RA Colony for forests, we have got Sanjay Gandhi National Park, right? So we have got even like all the different types of ecosystem forms also available. Then we have got these apna kya re wo area jahan par ye caves hai apne Mumbai mein, caves hai na idhar hi, Ellora, yeah. So wo caves bhi hai, to hills hai, mountains hai. If you have to go to Thane, now we have got that Ghodbandar road se jo bana hua hai, that's okay. But earlier na, there was this hill that has to, you know, like go round and round to cross and reach Thane. So Borivali to Thane jaane ke liye na, pehle wo ek hill tha, ek mountain tha, wo cross karna padta tha. So we have got all different you know, ecosystem forms also available. So I always give the example of Mumbai, right? Well, so that is about the biodiversity. Bio is living forms, diversity is the variation. And this term was given by whom? Edward Wilson. Okay. What are the levels of biodiversity? The biodiversity levels includes three interrelated hierarchical levels: genetic diversity, species diversity, and ecological diversity. So we have to study three levels of biodiversity or three forms of biodiversity. First will be at the genetic level, second will be at the species level, and third will be at the ecological level. Okay, so let us understand each of them very precisely. So these are the levels. The first one is genetic diversity. the genetic variations existing within a species is called as genetic diversity. Just like if you take Homo sapiens, right? If you take Homo sapiens, then in us, what are the different genetic diversities? Okay. For example, we have got Negroes, we have got mulattoes, we have got dark. I guess we'll have done this in principles of inheritance. You know what are Negroes, albinos, very dark, dark, fair, very fair. Ye aapne kiya hoga na? Aaya na? Principles of inheritance chapter mein. You want me to go to the previous slide? Go, but come on, tell me. Have you all done about the principles of inheritance chapter? Have you all done about the skin color? So you know now what is the ratio of your polygenes? 3 gene ke polygene ka ratio kya hai? बोलो बेटा पॉलीजीन्स 3 जीन्स का पॉलीजीन्स का रेशियो क्या है बेटा व्हाट इज द रेशियो ऑफ 3 जीन पॉलीजीन्स नो 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 नॉट 1:1 अरे दैट नीग्रो मैरीज एंड अल्बिनो नहीं किया है पॉलीजीन्स No, it's not 1:4:6:4:1. 1:4:6:4:1 is for wheat kernel color. That is of 2 genes inheritance. I'm talking about 3 genes. 1:6:15:20:15:6:1. Make kya? It is important. Huh? You all haven't done. How is it possible? You all have done wheat kernel color ka polygenes. It's done na. Because without that, sir won't move to microbes ka chapter. Now he has started with microbes na. So definitely principles has got completed. So that is your. It's not trihybrid, my dears. It's not trihybrid. It's polygenes. There's a vast difference between trihybrid cross and polygenic inheritance. It's not trihybrid, though there are. Okay, anyway, I won't get into it now. When I'll look at it later on. But it is that diversity that I'm talking about. A Negro is going to have a gene pool of capital A, capital A, capital B, capital B, capital C, capital C. That's the gene pool, or that is the genetic makeup of the Negro. The albino will have what? Small a, small b, small c. That is the genetic makeup of the albinos. And when they marry each other, you get mulattoes. Mulattoes ka matlab saula color hota hai. Saula jo bolte hai na hum log Hindi mein, saula. That is mulatto color. And when mulattoes will marry each other, do saule log marry karne ke baad, what are the conditions? So we have got a checkerboard of 64 possibilities. And there you have got the possibility of being born as a Negro or being born as an albino with so many permutation combinations. Hai na? Yes, yes, exactly. So that is called as a gene pool for one species. So Homo sapiens ka agar aap gene pool dekhoge to kitna zyada ho jata hai, dekhiye. Get me? Understood? Like that way, we are going to talk about the variation may be in alleles, it may be in total genes, or it may be in the chromosome structures also. Okay, so that is how the genetic diversity is explained. Well, so number of genes in the following examples: mycoplasma has got 450 to 700 genes, E. coli 4000, Drosophila melanogaster 13000, Oryza sativus is your eyes 32000 to 50000, Homo sapiens. Look at this. 45,000 to 45,000 genes only, whereas it was estimated that it is about more than a lakh. Okay, that's it. So we have got 46 chromosomes or 23 pairs, as we say, but the number of genes are only this much, and almost all have been explored. But there are still few which are need to be explored ki wo kya function karte hain, abhi tak hame guarantee nahi hai. To ye field mein research ke liye bahut zyada scope hai. Okay, anyway, so that is the genetic diversity. A single species might show high diversity at genetic level over its distributional range, as in case of human beings. The ones who are going to be in the African continent, their color differences, you know, clearly we can distinguish them as compared to Indians, as compared to Americans, Asians. Okay, so alag alag distribution ke hisab se alag alag hamara gene pool specifically banta jata hai, adapt ho jata hai. Right, my screen is lagging. I don't think, is my screen lagging now? No na bacha, check your connection. The genetic variation shown by the medicinal plant, remember this name of this medicinal plant, Rauwolfia vomitaria. What is the name? Rauwolfia vomitaria, growing in different Himalayan ranges, might be in terms of the potency and concentration of the active chemical called as rizopine that the plant produces. So what is going to happen, I'll tell you. See, this particular plant called as Rauwolfia vomitaria is a plant which is going to grow in Himalayan regions. Okay, but as the genetic diversity prevails in them, some of the plants will produce the chemical called as rizopine. The name of that chemical is rizopine, which is going to be you know, helpful in treating asthma. Ye jo Rauwolfia vomitaria hai na beta, ये अस्थमा को क्योर करने के लिए यूज किया जाता है. द नेम ऑफ दैट मेडिसिनल केमिकल इज रिजरपाइन. ओके, तो ये रिजरपाइन नाम का केमिकल है. इट विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इन द प्लांट्स कॉल्ड एज Rauwolfia vomitaria. ठीक है, अब कोई कोई प्लांट्स में ऐसा जेनेटिक मेकअप है कि द अमाउंट ऑफ रिजरपाइन विल बी मोर बट इट्स पोटेंसी विल बी लेस. ओके, while there are certain genetic diversities seen in from this Rauwolfia, that the amount of rizopine is very little but it is highly potent. Okay, so that is called as genetic diversity found in the same species of Rauwolfia vomitaria. Did you all understand? No, it's an angiosperm. okay, Rauwolfia. So isme kya hame pata chalta hai beta, कि जैसे जेनेटिक मेकअप है ना, वैसे अमाउंट ऑफ रिजोफाइन बन रहा है और वैसे स्ट्रॉन्ग या वीक केमिकल बन रहा है. इट डिपेंड्स ऑन द जेनेटिक डाइवर्सिटी. ओके, सो दैट इज वन एग्जांपल. लुक एट द सेकंड एग्जांपल. इंडिया हैज मोर देन 50,000 जेनेटिकली डिफरेंट स्ट्रेन्स ऑफ राइस एंड अराउंड 1,000 वराइटीज ऑफ मैंगोज. आपको 10-12 नाम पता होंगे ना मैंगोज के. कितने वैरायटीज है देखो, मोर देन 1,000 वैरायटीज ऑफ मैंगोज. ओ माय गॉड, कहाँ छिपे हुए है ना. हमें तो वो नॉर्मल जो नाम पता है वही पता है. कौन कौन से पता है तुम्हें मैंगो के नाम, चलो बोलो मुझे. विच ऑल नेम्स यू नो अबाउट मैंगोज, हाउ मेनी स्पीशीज, लेट अस काउंट. अल्फांसो, ओके, वन नेम. सेकेंड, दूसरा कौन सा है, केसर. ओके, then dashari. yes, dashari, dashara, whatever dashari is called as, correct. pyri, yes, langda, 5. fir badami, 6. ha badami 6. fir kaun se hai, rajapuri mujhe pata hai, 7. kesar count kya, totapuri 8. rajapuri 7, totapuri 8. chalo, aur kisi ko koi pata hai kya, बनारसी भी आता है, चलो ठीक है, 9. और कौन सा ऐसा, आई हैव नेवर हर्ड, कीट, ओके, 10. 1000 है, 1000 से ज्यादा मैंगो की वैरायटीज है जो रेगुलर जो हमें पता है. हीम सागर, इवन आई हैव हर्ड अबाउट इट, हीम सागर करके. अमरापाली, अमरापाली इज ऑल्सो, Indura. Oh my God, nice. It's Indura. Okay, great. हाँ तोतापुरी दशहरी तो हाँ तो मैक्सिमम 10, 12, 15 ले लो, चलो 20 ले लो. वी ओनली नो हार्डली मैक्सिमम 20 नेम्स, बट देर आर मोर देन 1000 वैरायटीज इज व्हाट इट्स बीइंग यू नो ऑलरेडी रिकॉर्डेड. सो मैंगो अलोन हैज गॉट अ जेनेटिक पूल ऑफ 100,000 डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ यू नो जेनेटिक वेरिएशन. गॉट इट? सो दैट इज योर जेनेटिक वेरायटी or genetic variability. Got this? Understood? Yeah, don't forget Raoul Wolffia vomitaria and the chemical called as rizopine, and 50,000 plus species of rice and 10,000 plus species of mangoes. Hai na? exactly my idea. Yes, Komal, you are right beta. Well, then we come to species diversity. Okay. So just now we talked about what? Gene diversity or genetic diversity. So within one species, there could be many differences. Now we come to species diversity. So see, the diversity at the species level is called as species diversity. For example, the Western Ghats have a greater amphibian species diversity than the Eastern Ghats. Yes, they are talking about India. So India ke jo Western Ghats hai na, usme amphibians zyada hai as compared to the Eastern Ghats. The species diversity depends upon the number of the species and the richness of the species of a particular region. So what is the species richness? The species richness is defined as the number of species per unit area. Now this is something which I'll explain, don't worry. Before I go to ecological diversity, I'll explain this. What is species evenness? And what is species richness? इसमें हमेशा marks जाते हैं बेटा आपके, और इसके ऊपर इसीलिए every year एक ऐसा twisted question आता है जिसमें आप confused होके आप गलत answer mark करके ही आओगे. So I don't want anyone of you all to lose this mark. So please pay very good attention to whatever I am going to put up on the whiteboard now. ठीक है? Please pay attention, my dears. I'm showing you the difference between two important words, that is species richness and species evenness. I'm drawing two circles almost of the same size. Okay. Now, I'll take another color, or I'll do one thing. This is a very important concept, my dears. So you should know what is this that I'm making. Of course, I'll explain that. You would say, what miss is doing A, B, C, D, kya bana rahi hai, hai na? Yeh iska important hai, beta. Now in these two circles, you can see I have randomly made, species A, species B, species C, species D, and species E in this particular circle. Here I have made only A and B, right? So from this we can easily conclude that what is our conclusion? कि यहाँ पर क्या है? यहाँ पर A के सिर्फ एक दो तीन चार चार ही ऑर्गेनिजम्स हैं जो A स्पीशीज को बिलोंग करते हैं. B के सिर्फ दो ऑर्गेनिजम्स हैं. C के एक दो तीन ऑर्गेनिजम्स हैं. D का एक ही है. E का भी एक ही है. यहाँ पर अगर देखोगे तो A के कितने हैं, देखो 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and B is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 9 are A and 5 are B. यहाँ पर mixed है. B और E तो एक एक ही है, right? But when we talk about species richness, it is going to be different types of number of species present in that area is species richness. And species evenness is maybe only one or two types of species, but they are present in large numbers. Okay? So ये जो है ना बेटा, ये जो example है, ये example है अपने species richness का. Okay? और ये जो अपना example है, ये वाला, this is capital होना चाहिए. ये है अपना स्पीशीज का इवननेस. ओके, सो यू अंडरस्टूड व्हाट इज इवननेस एंड व्हाट इज रिचनेस. सो व्हेन देयर आर नंबर ऑफ स्पीशीज प्रेजेंट, नंबर ऑफ स्पीशीज मींस डिफरेंट नंबर ऑफ स्पीशीज प्रेजेंट, इट विल बी रिचनेस. एंड व्हेनेवर इट्स गोइंग टू बी द सेम टाइप ऑफ स्पीशीज बट इन लार्ज नंबर्स, इट विल बी इवननेस. तो यहाँ पर हमेशा गड़बड़ करते हैं लोग, हमेशा गड़बड़ करते हैं. सो आई जस्ट डोंट वांट एनी वन ऑफ यू ऑल टू मेक दिस ब्लंडर, मेक दिस मिस्टेक. ओके, काइंडली कॉपी डाउन दिस बेटा, काइंडली कॉपी डाउन दिस. व्हाट इज स्पीशीज रिचनेस एंड व्हाट इज स्पीशीज इवननेस, कम ऑन क्विकली. So when we say about species diversity, we are talking about species richness, my dear. Okay, whenever you are talking about species diversity, we are talking about species richness. Done? Okay, fine. Can I clear it? Can I go back to our discussion on? Yeah, so now you understood what I'm trying to tell you, that is what is species diversity. Okay, so the number of species per unit area, number of species means different numbers or different types of species present per unit area is going to be your species richness. Okay, and then we come to ecological diversity. So the diversity of the ecosystem level is called as ecological diversity. For example, deserts, rainforest, mangroves, coral reef, wetlands, estuaries, alpine meadows, फिर क्या है अपने सवानास, है ना, पेरियार्स, ये जो सारे हैं ना, ये सारे अलग अलग examples of ecological diversity. So how the ecology is different in this entire, you know, on this earth is something that is called as your ecological diversity. So genetic diversity is between the same species, species diversity is between two different species, and ecological diversity is with different ecological habitats present for the sustenance of these diverse organisms. So three levels of biodiversity: genetic, species, ecological. Anyone who has not understood this concept of levels of biodiversity, beta, anyone who has got any difficulty, No. All have understood everything. Good. Yeah. So you can see rainforest is one ecological diversity, mangroves, estuaries, and coral reefs. All are going to be the examples of ecological diversity. You can see the diverse forms by yourselves. How different are they, na? Then we come to global species diversity all over the globe. According to IUCN 2004 report, the total number of plant and animal species is more than 1.5 million. Robert May estimated that global species diversity is about 7 million. More than 70% of the species recorded are animals, and rest are going to be, of course, the plants, which will include algae, fungi, bryophytes, gymnosperms, angiosperms, which is going to be around 22%. Okay, so around 70% is going to be the animals, and around 22% is going to be the plants, is what has been estimated by IUCN in the year 2004. Okay, now among animals, insects are making up more than 70% of the total. We know, right? Maximum diversity is of insects only. So out of every 10 animals on this planet, 7 would be insects alone. Oh my God, that's just too much, na? The number of fungi species in the world is more than the combined total of the species of fish, amphibians, reptiles, and mammals. Oh my God, look at the fungal species ki diversity. It's a combination of fishes ke species plus amphibians ke species plus reptile ke species plus mammal ke species. Itne hone ke baad jitna number aayega na, utne fungal species hai. Aur hame ascomycetes ke kuch 10-12 naam yaad rakhne hai to hame bahut difficult lagta hai, hai na? Ascomycetes ke agar maine puche, chalo give me the examples of ascomycetes, 2-3-4 aap mujhe de doge. Correct? कितने हैं देखो, सो मेनी ऑफ देम आर गोइंग टू बी देयर, व्हिच वी थैंकफुली डू नॉट हैव टू रिमेंबर. इंडिया हैज ओनली 2.4% ऑफ द वर्ल्ड्स टोटल लैंड एरिया, बट इट इज गोइंग टू कंट्रीब्यूट टू अराउंड 8.1% ऑफ द टोटल ग्लोबल स्पीशीज डाइवर्सिटी. सो दो ऑन एन एवरेज इफ यू टेक द एरिया ऑफ द लैंड दैट इज गिवन टू इंडिया, और इंडिया इज गोइंग टू बी, you know, occupying a land that is only 2.4% of the world's land, available land area. But in spite of that, look at the diversity contributed by India. It's around 8.1%. And therefore, India is considered as one of the biodiversity hotspots. So total, there are 12 mega diversity hotspots or 12 mega diversity countries in which India is included. Okay. And it has improved also in the last 10 years. The rank of India has come up. Wo 12 mega diversities mein apne jo hai wo abhi number thoda upar aa gaya hai. Yeah, so look at this. They are saying, look at the invertebrates ka group beta. So insects are almost 70%, followed by other animals, mollusks, and crustaceans. If you have read NCERT very precisely, for animal kingdom, they have given for mollusks, this is the second largest phylum of animal kingdom. Have you all read NCERT? ये sentence पढ़ा है आपने कि insects के लिए उन्होंने बोला है this is going to be the largest of the animal kingdom, and mollusks के यहाँ पर उन्होंने लिखा हुआ है NCERT में that mollusks form the second largest group of organisms after insects. So look at this. शेयर देखो, ये इसको हम पाई चार्ट कहते हैं ना, पाई डायग्राम. तो इसमें देखो बेटा, आफ्टर इंसेक्ट्स इज गोइंग टू बी द मॉलस्क एज वन सिंगल स्पीशीज, क्रस्टेशियंस उससे भी कम है, और बाकी जो है सारे मिक्स्ड है. अदर इनवर्टिब्रेट्स टुगेदर विल मेक अप दिस. लुक एट द वर्टिब्रेट्स, 50% फिश अलोन, राइट? एंड लुक एट दीज रेप्टाइल्स, बर्ड्स ऑलमोस्ट इक्वल, followed by mammals and amphibians almost equal, right? Plants देखो बेटा, fungi उन्होंने बोला है ना कि it's a combination of 4 different things together, that is your fungi all alone. And algae फिर भी है, थोड़े बहुत तो एल्गे दिखाई दे रहे हैं, मॉसेस कम है, फर्न्स कम है, लाइकेंस बिल्कुल भी कम है, अगेन एंजियोस्पर्म्स बहुत ज्यादा है. ओके, नाउ दीज डायग्राम्स गिवन इन योर एनसीईआरटी टेक्स्ट बुक्स एंड दे इन योर नीट एग्जामिनेशन दे विल पुट द लेबल एज एबीसीडी. एंड यहाँ पर अगर ए बी सी डी डाला तो आपको पता होना चाहिए ए कौन है, बी कौन है, सी कौन है, डी कौन है. यहाँ पर भी ऐसे ही डालेंगे. सो बी वेरी केयरफुल विद द नेम्स एंड व्हाट मच एरिया दे ऑक्यूपाई ऑन दिस पाई चार्ट. ठीक है, सो दीज आर प्रोपोर्शनेट नंबर्स व्हिच हैव बीन प्लेस्ड इन दिस पाई चार्ट फॉर्म ऑफ प्लांट्स, इनवर्टिब्रेट्स एंड वर्टिब्रेट्स. ओके, देन वी कम टू पैटर्न्स ऑफ बायोडाइवर्सिटी. So how different patterns of biodiversity have been given for understanding. So biodiversity is not uniform throughout the world, but it shows uneven distribution, obviously. है ना, अलग अलग टाइप के होते हैं. So it can be affected by two factors. Biodiversity इतना changed क्यों है, एक जगह पर ऐसा है तो दूसरी जगह पर अलग क्यों है, why there is so much of variation. So they're saying it is because of two reasons. First, latitudinal gradient and second species area relationship. Yeah beta, yeah you're right, they are lichens are fungi and algae, but yet they are very small. Yes, because as composite organisms na they are not going to flourish too much, that's why. Okay, so what are the two different patterns of biodiversity, if the question is going to come in your board exams, that explain the patterns of biodiversity citing examples. You have to give these two. Latitudinal gradient. You know what is latitude and longitude, I hope. Species area relationship. ये दो के वजह से uniformity नहीं है पूरे earth पे. These are the two major reasons that why there is so much of variation of species on this entire globe. Fine. Let us go ahead with latitudinal gradient. In general, species diversity decreases as we move away from the equator towards the poles. Obviously, near the equatorial region, maximum diversity will be there. Different species will be present over here. And as you move towards the polar regions, the number of organisms or the living forms are going to be becoming lesser and lesser. Few exceptions, that is tropics, which lie between the latitudinal range of 23.5 degrees north of the equatorial plain, okay, and 23.5 degrees south of the equatorial, harbors more species than temperate or polar regions. Colombia, who has raised the hand? Someone wants to say something? Anyone wants to say something, beta? Okay. No issues. Well, Colombia, located near the equator, has nearly 1,400 species of birds, while New York, which is at 41 degrees north, has 105 species. Greenland, which is 71 degrees north, has only 56 species. So imagine. Like this is the equator. Equator के पास कोलंबिया है, तो मैक्सिमम डाइवर्सिटी बर्ड्स की उधर है. 1,400 डिफरेंट स्पीशीज ऑफ बर्ड्स आर नियर द इक्वेटोरियल रीजन. और थोड़ा ऊपर जाएंगे ना, 41 डिग्रीज नॉर्थ जाएंगे, नियर द न्यूयॉर्क साइड, इट इज गोइंग टू हैव 105 स्पीशीज. एंड व्हेन यू गो टू ग्रीनलैंड, दैट इज 71 डिग्रीज नॉर्थ, इट्स गोइंग टू हैव ओनली 56 स्पीशीज. सो एज वी move away from the equator and go towards the north pole or the south pole, right, the species richness, that is species diversity, would go on decreasing. India, with much of its land area in the tropical latitudes, has more than 1,200 species of birds. So we are coming under, you know, subtropics. Okay, we are not temperate. India doesn't come under temperate. It doesn't come under tropics. It is subtropical, and therefore tropics se thoda sa kam diversity India mein hai. So Colombia se thoda sa kam. Colombia mein 1,400 bird species agar hai, so India has got 1,200 different bird species. Now that is what proves that as the latitudinal gradient changes, the number of species ka variation also goes on changing. So the first reason that why there is no evenness of species on this earth was latitudinal gradient, which is being proved by these examples. Got this? Clear? Clear? Any difficulty in this, my dears? Anyone having any difficulty? Look at the Amazon rainforest. The largely tropical Amazonian rainforest in South America has the greatest biodiversity on the earth. It is home to more than 40,000 species of plants, 3,000 fishes, 1,300 birds, 427 mammals, 427 amphibians, 378 reptiles, and more than 125,000 invertebrates. I'm very sorry, my dears, but you'll have to remember these figures. अब तक मैंने जितने भी फिगर्स बोले हैं ये सारे फिगर्स आपको याद रखने हैं. ये सारे फिगर्स आपके एनसीईआरटी से ही लिए गए हैं एंड दे आर गोइंग टू बी आस्क्ड वेरी ऑफन. सो यू शुड नो 125,000 कौन है अमेजोनियन फॉरेस्ट में, 1,300 कौन है, हाउ विच टू आर सेम इन नंबर्स लाइक मैमल्स एंड एम्फीबियंस आर बोथ 427 ईच. सो दीज टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस आर आस्क्ड. You know, they give that greater than, lesser than wala sign. And they say, who is going to be, you know, like Amazonian forest, maximum, usse kam, usse kam, usse kam, usse kam, is equal to, aise aata hai beta. So, isi liye na, ye wala jo figures hai na, memorize them. It's important. Okay? Well, so this is the diversity found in Amazonian forest, which is in South America. Many people do not know Amazonian forest kahan par hai. It's called as Amazonian rainforest. And where is it? People are still not aware. Okay. Well, greater biological diversity is seen in tropics. Various hypotheses for higher diversity in tropics have been proposed by ecologists and evolutionary biologists, which are as follows. Temperate regions have undergone frequent glaciations, means बहुत बार ग्लेशियर्स फॉर्म हुए बिगड़ गए ओके इन द पास्ट. देयरफॉर इट किल्ड मोस्ट ऑफ द स्पीशीज. ट्रॉपिकल लैटिट्यूड्स हैव रिमेन्ड रिलेटिवली अनडिस्टर्ब्ड फॉर मिलियंस ऑफ इयर्स. सो दे हैव रीच्ड द क्लाइमैक्स कम्युनिटी. हु? द ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट. सो द ट्रॉपिकल लैटिट्यूड्स हैव ऑलमोस्ट रीच्ड द क्लाइमैक्स कम्युनिटी. सो नाउ दे आर इन दैट सस्टेनेंस मोड. And therefore, there is nothing that is going to be made and destroyed. They have already attained the climax community. So from nudation to sustenance, all 10 major steps have been completed in tropics. Okay, now you can correlate the things, right? Whereas in temperate, what is happening? In temperate regions, there are, you know, continuous, some of the other changes that are taking place. Like glaciers bante hai, bigadte hai. इसके वजह से है ना ये जो कंडीशंस चेंज होते हैं दैट किल्स मेजॉरिटी ऑफ द स्पीशीज एट दैट पर्टिकुलर टाइम. दिस हैज हैपेंड. ट्रॉपिकल एनवायरनमेंट्स आर लेस सीजनल व्हिच प्रमोट निक स्पेशलाइजेशन एंड लीड टू ग्रेटर स्पीशीज डाइवर्सिटी. नाउ व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय दिस वर्ड निक? आई विल टेल यू. सो दे आर सेइंग इन ट्रॉपिकल एनवायरनमेंट्स देयर इज नॉट गोइंग टू बी मेनी सीजनल वेरिएशंस. दे आर गोइंग टू हैव a constant climatic conditions throughout the year. Okay, so what happens? Because there is going to be constancy of the environmental conditions, there is going to be constancy of the species also. Ek bada, ek kam hua, aisa nahi hota hai wahan par, right? Which promotes niche specialization. Some people call it as niche, some call it out as niche, some call it out as nike, whatever you want, I call it as niche. ओके, सो व्हाट इज दिस निक? निक का मतलब होता है द स्पीशीज इन अ हैबिटेट एंड इट्स इंटरैक्शन विद द हैबिटेट. स्पीशीज इन अ हैबिटेट एंड इट्स इंटरैक्शन विद द हैबिटेट. फॉर एग्जांपल ग्रासेस आर गोइंग टू बी ऑक्यूपाइंग व्हाट? टेरेस्ट्रियल हैबिटेट. व्हाट इज देयर इंटरैक्शन? दे आर प्रोड्यूसर्स. ओके, सो उनका एक रोल, उनका एक फंक्शन डिफाइन हो जाता है उस एरिया का, उसको हम कहते हैं निक. सो निक क्या है बेटा? एक एरिया विच विल बी ऑक्यूपाइड बाय अ पर्टिकुलर स्पीशीज एंड इट्स फंक्शनल रोल विद द एनवायरनमेंट, दैट विल बी कॉल्ड एज द निक. हैव यू ऑल अंडरस्टूड व्हाट इज द निक? क्या होता है निक? कम ऑन वन मोर टाइम. अ प्लेस ऑक्यूपाइड बाय एन ऑर्गेनिज्म एंड इट्स फंक्शनल रोल इन द इकोसिस्टम, whether it's a producer, primary consumer, secondary consumer, tertiary consumer, detritus or a detrivore, decomposer, what is its role and that place where it has occupied, okay, that is going to be called as the nick. So because there is no variations, this nick also is going to get stabilized. There is specialization ki ye hamesha idhar rahega aur iska kaam ye rahega. बहुत स्मूथ वर्किंग हो जाता है फिर. इफ द वर्क इज डिफाइंड, इफ यू नो व्हाट इज द वर्क, इट बिकम्स वेरी सिंपल. दिस इज कॉल्ड एज निक स्पेशलाइजेशन व्हिच लीड्स टू ग्रेटर स्पीशीज डाइवर्सिटी. सो दैट कॉजेज व्हाट? मोर नंबर ऑफ स्पीशीज रिचनेस यहाँ पर ट्रॉपिकल रेन फॉरेस्ट में पाया गया है. गॉट इट? एंड दे ऑल आर हैप्पीली लिविंग, दे डोंट हैव द थ्रेट ऑफ एनवायरमेंटल स्ट्रेस. Okay. More solar energy is available in the tropics, which contributes to higher productivity and in turn might contribute indirectly to greater diversity. So these are the reasons, you know, like they are trying to tell that because of latitudinal stratifications, the conditions are different all over the world. And how are they different? Why tropics are going to be more sustainable and why are they more reaching a climax community, or they have reached a climax community. So they have given these reasons for it. ठीक है? ये easy है, ये actually logical है बहुत ही, कि tropical areas में climate stable रहता है, ज्यादा species diversity होती है, variations कम दिखते हैं, है ना? And the second fact that they want to talk about is species area relationship. Now, this particular phenomenon was given by Alexander Humboldt. He is Mr. Alexander von Humboldt. So, Alexander von Humboldt was a German naturalist and explorer. He observed that within a region, species richness increased with increasing explored area, but only up to a limit. The relationship between species richness and area for a wide variety of taxa is to be a rectangular hyperbola. अब यहाँ पर पैराबोला एंड हाइपरबोला वर्ड सुनते ही मैथमेटिक्स की याद आ जाती है. हाँ बेटा, he was a naturalist, he believed in maths as well, and he has given his findings on hyperbolas and parabolas. So what is his way of thinking? Just I'll tell you in a common man's language. Common man's language बताती हूँ. According to Alexander von Humboldt, as we go on increasing the area, the number of different types of organisms would be included in that area, causing species richness. ठीक है? But only up to a certain limit. उसके बाद अगर हमने और area को include कराने की कोशिश करी ना, तो क्या हो जाता है? Average out होके species richness की value कम हो जाती है. जैसे कि चलिए मैं एकदम सिंपल सिंपल लैंग्वेज में आपको बताती हूँ. बताइए, बिल्कुल इजी लैंग्वेज में इमेजिन कीजिएगा कि आपकी नीट की एग्जाम जो है वो फिजिक्स केमिस्ट्री बायोलॉजी पे बेस्ड है. करेक्ट? अब आई विल नॉट नेम एनी पर्टिकुलर सब्जेक्ट. अगेन आई ऑलवेज से दैट ऑल सब्जेक्ट्स आर इक्वली इजी एंड इक्वली इम्पॉर्टेंट. ओके, सपोज सब्जेक्ट ए है, सब्जेक्ट बी है, सब्जेक्ट सी है. ये तीन सब्जेक्ट्स के ऊपर आपकी एग्जाम होने वाली है. राइट? अब इन तीन में से अगर आप सिर्फ एक सब्जेक्ट लेते हो, उसमें आपको मैक्सिमम मार्क्स मिलते हैं. यू गेट मैक्सिमम मार्क्स इन सब्जेक्ट ए. सपोज Now what will happen? That is your species evenness. one particular type of species can be found in a particular area lavishly growing. When we go ahead with subject B, so B में आपके थोड़े से marks A से कम है, ठीक है. So हम लोग जितने subjects बढ़ाए उतना आपका एवरेज कम हो गया. सब्जेक्ट सी है उसमें आपको बी से भी थोड़े से कम आते हैं, है ना. तो एज वी इंक्रीज द नंबर ऑफ सब्जेक्ट्स योर एवरेज गोज डाउन, राइट. इन द सेम वे बेटा एज वी एक्सप्लोर मोर एंड मोर स्पीशीज, एज वी एक्सप्लोर मोर एंड मोर स्पीशीज इंडिविजुअली, हाँ दैट्स फाइन. बट वेन वी combine that particular areas with the number of species, we might get an average out number to be less. ठीक है. तो किसी किसी का subject A बहुत अच्छा है, किसी किसी का subject B बहुत अच्छा है, किसी का subject C बहुत अच्छा है, तीन अलग अलग individuals के. लेकिन वो तीन अलग अलग individuals है ना. जब एक बंदे की बात करते हैं तो अगर हम एक species की बात करते हैं so it will be confined to a particular area. As we take in more area, what will happen? The average out number will become reduced. So that is what a species area relationship put forward by Alexander von Humboldt. Now, do you understand what he is trying to tell you all now? So he is saying that he observed within a region, species richness is increased with increasing explored area within that same region, okay, but only up to a limit. If we combine another area besides it, then average out mein species number kam ho jayega. Any confusion with the wordings of Alexander von Humboldt beta? Anyone who did not follow any part, any point of this parabola batati hu main, don't worry, but idhar tak clear. Well, what is he saying? See, if we plot those particular species area relationship ke average values, okay, and if we consider more areas, then it will become a parabola. Then that shape of that graph will become a parabola, is what he is saying. Yeah. So on the logarithmic scale, the relationship is a straight line. Okay, log ke scale pe this is going to be a straight line. Described by the equation like log s is equal to log c plus z log a, where s is species richness, which is going on increasing, a is area, z is the slope of line, or we call it as regression coefficient, and c is the y intercept. C is the y intercept. Okay, you don't have to worry. Till today and even henceforth, never ever there would be any mathematical problem placed on this equation. You only have to ratta marofai this equation, baki kuch nahi karna hai. Kya ratta marna hai? Log s is equal to log c plus z log a, ye aapko ratta marna hai, baki kuch nahi karna hai. Iske upar aapko koi bhi question mathematics ke hisab se nahi aayega beta. Okay, but remember the equation on the logarithmic scale. And here you can see on this hyperbolic scale, agar dekhenge to s is equal to c a to the power z. Everything remains the same. Species richness is equal to y intercept multiplied by area raised to slope of the line. So this is the hyperbolic expression. This is the logarithmic expression. So what is the question? Please look at that question very carefully. If they are asking about the hyperbolic expression, on an hyperbolic expression, s is equal to c a raised to z. And if it is logarithmic scale, it is going to be log s is equal to log c plus z log a. ठीक है? Species area relationship. Okay. So importance of species diversity to the ecosystem is something which I need to have a continuity again. So from this point onwards, I'll take up in our next class, I guess on Thursday, right? And we'll go ahead with the chapter on Thursday. We'll continue this chapter on Thursday. Fine. So up till here, anyone is having any problem in understanding, my dears? Yes. Have you all understood this thing very precisely? No issues. Okay, fine. यहाँ तक मैंने स्टॉप किया है. इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ स्पीशीज डाइवर्सिटी टू द इकोसिस्टम तक उसके पहले का हमने कंप्लीट करा लिया. ओके, दैट्स इट फॉर टुडे एंड थैंक यू सो मच. सी ऑल, कीप स्टडिंग, स्टडी फ्रॉम योर एनसीईआरटी स्पेसिफिकली फॉर दीज चैप्टर्स. ओके, बाय बाय.